What's cracking, fam? So, I got up, I did the news this morning, or I put it out, and I was just checking the Twitter feed and I come across this. And I want to get these questionable started up again anyway. And this was just a perfect thing, perfect thread to go through. I got a couple of threads actually I'm gonna go through with you, but this is the first one. Hey, questionable is back. What's cracking? Let's get it, right? So, public concern for Justin Bieber's well-being. This is in the light of P. Diddy's arrest, right? And people are remembering how things were with P. Diddy back in the day. And everybody's kind of wondering, some of the things that Justin has done or said and gone through don't look so crazy. It's how it is, right? Like the crazy people starting to look less and less crazy, right? So anyway, check it out. Into Thin Air says, "Happy Sunday." This is what got me started. This is what kicked the whole thing off for me. Hope you are having a great weekend. I know I am. These two dudes deleted all their social media posts because Diddy is locked up. No mercy or sympathy for any of these deceivers. I can't wait to watch each of these demons fall one by one. That's according to Into Thin Air. Now, when you go down this is actually kind of funny. His niece says, "Pink's a dude." And Into Thin Air replies with the Maverick post, and he's showing the Adonis belt. Pink is a man with an obvious Adonis belt. Can y'all see that? Let me click on that for you. So that's what's being said about Pink. I don't know if y'all knew that. But yeah, I knew that. Ren says, "Pink is not a dude." So I replied and showed him all these pictures here. Yeah, that's the body of a dude with some. But look, here's the thing. See, personally, I don't know nothing, right? I don't land on, I know I ain't been down there, right? I don't know nothing, but I know what I'm seeing right now, what I'm showing you is something that only men have. The Adonis belt are these little lines at her waist that go into where her pelvic area is. And men have those and women don't. Let's see if I could find something. Women don't have Adonis. Oh, look at this Adonis belt on women. Let's check it out. Go to images. Yeah, no, that's not an Adonis belt. Estrogenic pear-shaped body. Yeah, okay. Well, that's how guys do it. Let's see what else we got. Yeah, see, this is right. That line that goes into your pelvis there, that's strictly a male thing. And it said women with Adonis belt, and I'm not seeing any. So let's see, Adonis belt on women. Let's see if we can do it like this. Width and about. And let's see if we can look. See, y'all can see the difference. I don't know. They're showing the women. How come I don't see the women? But that should let you know also that only men have Adonis belts. So that does kind of prove my point. Without Adonis belt, women versus men. See that. Man, they are not showing it. Okay. Men versus women bodies. Right. Now let's see if we can get. No. Now, when they say that they'd be censoring the internet and changing shit up so you can't find it? Let's see what we got here. All right. Now we got some women. All right. Let's see. All right. Here's a woman in the front. Let's see what she looks like. All right. Now you notice she does not have an Adonis belt. That was a long time to find a woman naked. I could find y'all women naked doing all kind of stuff, but I can't seem to find y'all just standing there. That's funny. Okay. Anyway, okay, here's an athletic woman, I think. Yeah, that's an athletic woman, and I don't see the Adonis belt. It's just not there. But I can't tell. She looks like she might be spray painted. You know, that's not really a great representation. I just want to see a man and a woman standing up naked. Let me see what we got here. Well, these are all guys. Anyway, take a minute and do your own research. But women do not have. Ah, look, check this out. These are fake. Okie dokie. But still, she don't got one. Gonna try one last thing. Women, naked bodies. Do I have like a safe search filter on or some shit? Like, what the hell is really going on? All right, I don't want to stay on this forever, but safe search off. Okay, now it's got y'all doing all kind of stuff. So, all right. All right, let's check it out. Again, no Adonis belt. Just trying to show y'all. All right. So when we come back to pink and we see this Adonis belt there at her waistline, that's very, very suspect. All right. And as you can see why. All right. Back to public concern for Justin Bieber. You know, interestingly enough, let's see if I could do this real quick. Pink and Usher both deleted their Instagrams, but also so did it's gone already. Oh my God. Archive all celebrity social media yesterday. Whoa, it's gone already. Somebody else erased all their social media, and I'm trying to remember who it was. Oh man, that's crazy. All right. Diddy with the wig on at a freak off is very crazy. This nigga thought he was oof.
So we coming to you live, Diddy late nights, when anything can happen, I'm just vibing, it's so wild, so wild.
Okay, bringing it back to public concern. All right, so we know the rumors about Pink, right? We know Usher was very involved with Diddy back in the day, right? So Cat Turd says the fallout from Diddy's arrest is going to be huge. Holy shit, Usher deleted all the social media. All right, so creepy.org says, in light of the Diddy arrest, can we talk about this picture again? Now, have you guys seen this picture? All right, I'm gonna show it to you because it's time for it right now. So JLo puts out this picture and people notice in the background this here, and it appears to be, I don't know if that's a kid with a hand over their mouth or what, but that appears to be some creepy type shit in the JLo photo, huh? I mean, you know, what's really going on? Why don't you put that shit away before you started taking pictures, right? Yeah, okay. All right. So apparently all kind of creepy shit is gonna start to come out over this Diddy thing. So I'm here for it. Let's see, Justin Bieber hits different now. He was just a kid. Hope he's okay now. All right.
Everybody saw me sick. Everybody saw me
All right, let's see what else they're digging up here. You guys need to stop claiming Justin is a victim of Diddy with no solid proof at all. There are real victims who have come forward, tweet about their story for awareness, and stop using Justin's name for likes with no proof to what you're saying. And he's right, you know, ain't nobody, I mean, I ain't seen the tapes of the Diddy compound or whatever, but then you see stuff like this, and it's just so suspect. I mean, check it out.
So I'm gonna be driving this next year.
Yeah, when you get 16, you come down there, you gotta, you know, wear your seat.
I mean, I'm 15, you can ride in the passenger seat. I got my permit. Now that
so like here's my thing. So just because they get rewarded for whatever they do, it doesn't mean that they had a choice in what they do. You know, I mean, I hear stories like you can either do this or we can kill your whole family. You could do this and get rich, or we can kill your whole family type shit. So, and you know about the mafia, like you know in the mob or the mafia, right? To get in tight, you got to do some crazy shit so that you know, they can trust you, right? You got to make your bones when you jumping in with it, with the in the even in the hood, you got to pop some, you know what I'm saying? You know what it is. You got to do something to get in. Otherwise, they don't trust your ass. So, you know, take that into consideration when you're watching this.
Not yet.
No.
16.
No,
16.
Slow down. Let's slow down, Josh.
Okay.
Let's slow down.
Okay. One step at a time.
But yeah, the keys is yours when you, you know, when you get 16. You're good to go.
I'm good to go.
Yeah.
All right.
And then when you get 18, you get the house. You get the mansion.
Okay. I get the mansion?
Yeah.
So where are we off to now?
Where would you like to go?
I mean, wherever you want to go. Where are we going?
We just. So check this out, yo. Justin, he's in, you ever seen the movie 48 Hours? Right now, he's having 48 hours with Diddy, him and his boy. They're having the times of their lives, like the, you know, where we hanging out and what we doing. We can't really disclose, but it's definitely a 15-year-old's dream.
I could not give my child to another
guy,
man.
I have been given custody of him. You know, he's on the Usher. I had legal guardianship of Usher when you know he did his first album. I did Usher's first album. I don't have legal guardianship of him, but for the next 48 hours, he's with me. So and we gonna go full, buck full crazy.
We're going crazy.
Crazy.
I'm taking this out tonight.
What you wanna do? What you wanna do over the next 48 hours?
48 hours. Let's go. Are we gonna? Let's just go get some girls. Let's go hang with some girls.
Yeah, man. Many videos of Diddy and Justin Bieber have been circulating, but I find this one particularly disturbing from Nick Sautor. This one shows a visibly uncomfortable 15-year-old Bieber being forced to spend 48 hours with Diddy doing things we really can't disclose, Diddy says. Meanwhile, Diddy is showering Bieber with gifts such as a Lamborghini and a new mansion. It's so obvious what's going on here. It's blatant grooming of Bieber, and I truly believe whatever Diddy did to him during those 48 hours led to Bieber falling off the deep end soon thereafter. Justin Bieber is a victim of Diddy, and he's since come out saying he wouldn't wish some of the horrors he's lived through on anyone, seeming to be referring to incidents like this. Am I off base here?
I definitely feel protective of her. It was hard for me being that young and being in the industry and not knowing where to turn, and everyone, you know, telling me they love me and, you know, just turn their back on you in a second. I don't want her to lose it. I don't want her to, you know, go through anything I went through. I don't wish that upon anybody. So, yeah, if she ever needs me, I'm just a call away.
If you could send your 10-year-old self one message from the future, what would that be?
I would say, you can and have and do call Justin Bieber at any given time. Anytime you want. Anytime you want, you can. And he'll answer.
That is amazing.
That's what I would say.
I don't know. It's a good question. What do you guys think? I think it's suspect, you know, that's all I could say, right? Fight for Humanity says he literally is freeing himself and I'm here for it. Yes, Justin Bieber, we are here for you. All right, what's that about? Look at all of these. All right. Now, Touré actually has a crazy story for you, too. NYC Strong says this is 100% true because any victim of Diddy knew he was so powerful at the time, they were too scared. And Diddy had cameras recording everything all over his houses and on bodyguards. So, peep this story.
The Diddy situation is personal for me. I take no joy in the man's downfall. I just want to see justice. But I too felt his wrath. I knew this man for decades. I interviewed him many times. I went to some of his PG-rated parties. We had a professional relationship until something happened. Some of you know the story, some of you don't. Many years ago, someone I loved immensely needed a break, and I called Puff and I said, "Hey, can you take my family member on as an intern?" And he did. I thought the bad boy internship program would be something that might accelerate this young person's career. Obviously, I had no knowledge at that time of the deviance that we all now know about. I had never before asked Puff for a favor, for a personal favor, but for someone I loved, for someone young, for someone who needed a break, I said, "This is the time to do it." For about 3 months, everything went great. The internship was very exciting, and then one day it abruptly ended after Puff said to my family member, "Either come home with me for the night, or the internship is over." He said no. At the time, all I knew was that the internship ended abruptly. I didn't find out what happened until years later. When I found out what had really happened, I was shocked. I was mortified. I was angry. I was upset on behalf of the family member that I had put into a horrible position. And I was blown away that Puff would do that to my family. Why didn't I speak out then? At the time, I didn't think that I'd be believed. I thought, I can't connect this with some larger pattern of behavior, him doing this to other people. Who knows how people will take this? Someone commented that I enabled him by saying nothing, and I think that word is too big to be truly accurate in this situation. I did not save him from a story that could have sank him. He was so powerful, I knew I had to come with more than that to make a dent. My story did not have the power to change people's minds about him. Some stories, for sure, can change the world, but some stories need the right time and the right context to be believed.
Yeah, so there's that too, right? AKA Jay Longbone says they're trying to woke Diddy's ass out of prison. What's going on here? The racist origins of the law at the center of Sean Diddy Combs' prosecution. Oh, Lord. But not the Mann Act, originally motivated by xenophobia, racism, and politicians looking for ways to punish consensual, immoral sex. The law remains a federal tool used to prosecute Combs. Yeah, I'm not buying that. I don't know how y'all feel about it in particular, but sending love to Bieber, this whole thing must be re-traumatizing, possibly. Jamie here says Justin Bieber was abused by the entire industry. It's a miracle he's still here and okay. And here from the shadow of Ezra, Khloe Kardashian reveals she attended Diddy's infamous butt naked parties. Okay. All right, Julia here says, I've never given Justin Bieber a thought until recently, but all this stuff coming out with Diddy has me legitimately grieving for the kid. I don't grieve for him because, I mean, the dude, look, he's doing better than you and me right now at the moment, but what he had to go through to get there, possibly, look, I don't know. I don't know nothing. I just know what's being said, right? And I know, and I'm just showing you the evidence that that supports it, basically. And basically, people are just kind of worried about him because, they know about the environment that he grew up in. So DS Production here retweeted JB Hassenpfeffer. I mean, y'all gotta see this, check it out.
Violated right now. Wow.
Get that off
hey,
there.
Hey, 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 hey. You have to be naked on stage during one full song. One full song. Answer Justin Bieber.
The crazy thing is,
I have like little girl fans. I can't go.
Okay, imagine there were so long.
It is. Lean into me again. You smell amazing. How old are you?
Thank you.
How old are you?
I'm 16. I'll be 17 in like 2 weeks.
I don't ever remember smelling that good at 16. Wow, look at your eyes. What? So look at him. Look at what a beautiful face. All right.
It was Katy Perry who apparently wanted to know what a Bieber butt felt like.
Squeeze your
no,
face.
No, I was, no, no, no,
I mean, no.
Squeeze your face.
Canadian high school. This with me. Let's do it together.
That makes me feel uncomfortable.
I just want to protect her, I don't want her to go through anything I went through. I don't wish that upon anybody.
And what's interesting about that is, Billie Eilish does seem like she's going through something, right? I mean, look, I don't know nothing, but it looked like she's going through something, don't it? Dr. Jack says this P. Diddy thing is so much bigger than most realize. This is bonkers. Yeah, Dr. Jack, I tend to agree with you on that, bro. We'll see how this shit plays out, right? This P. Diddy stuff is going to get messy, y'all, right? Hollywood stars are scared to death to speak out about Sean Diddy Combs sex trafficking. From the New York Post. Oof. All right. Okay. All right. There's no speculation surrounding Justin Bieber being SA'd by adults. Okay. Abused by adults. This woman abused him in public. He literally said he felt violated. Diddy party.
Lost myself at a Diddy party. Didn't know that's how it go. I was in it for a new Ferrari, but it cost me way more than my soul. Wasn't worth all the fortune and fame. All the girls never walking the same. Signed the paper so he never has to ever say sorry. Lost myself at a Diddy party.
Well, okay. All right.
I feel violated right now.
Harry, who apparently wanted to know what a Bieber butt felt like.
Thank you. How old are you? I'm 16. I'll be 17 in like 2 weeks.
I don't ever remember smelling that good when I was 16. Like, I was not a fan. Wow, look at your eyes. And what music do you listen to?
Get that off of there.
Hey, 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 hey.
Things on blast, you know.
You want to say it again? You have beautiful lips.
Oh, thank you, man. Thank you, bro.
You have good lips.
Thank you.
Just wear pants. Yeah, serious.
I want to protect her, you know. I don't want her to go through anything I want.
What's up, man? You good?
I'm good. How are you?
All right, young brother, everything's good. Selling out arenas and everything. Yeah. Starting to act different, huh? You ain't been calling me and hanging out the way we used to hang out.
Well, I mean, you try to get in contact with me, you know, through all my, you know, partners and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
But you never really got my number, so.
Right. Okay.
My number?
Yeah.
It's 555.
Yes.
Justin Bieber has finally exposed the shocking truth about grooming in Hollywood. And boy, is it a mouthful. It seems like, from Diddy and Will Smith to Clive Davis, there is a network of Hollywood top guns that habitually groom young artists in the name of mentorship. The worst part is no one seems to be doing anything about it. According to Justin, the industry actively tries to protect these groomers because of how powerful they are. Not him, though. He has had enough and is not afraid to call out the BS. So, what does Justin Bieber have to say about grooming in Hollywood? And who exactly are the perpetrators of abuse and exploitation of children in Hollywood? Let's find out.
It's hard for me being that young and being in the industry and not knowing where to turn and everyone, you know, telling me they love me and, you know, just turn their back on you in a second. So if she ever needs me, I'm gonna be here for her. But yeah, just protecting those moments because people take for granted encounters and I just want to protect her.
Justin Bieber is breaking his silence about his experiences in Hollywood and how the industry is filled with corrupt individuals who love to groom children. One individual in particular who has allegedly taken part in grooming Justin Bieber and other young artists is, of course, Diddy. In the past couple of weeks, Diddy has been slammed with a number of lawsuits accusing him of SA, sparking a chain reaction that has encouraged more of his victims to speak up. This includes all the men and young boys that Diddy has allegedly groomed through his years in the industry, especially Justin Bieber and Usher. Rumors of Diddy being gay have been rampant since the 1990s, but his closet sexuality, or lack thereof, is not the main issue. The issue is that he allegedly uses his power and proximity to young men and boys to abuse, exploit, and take advantage of them. Take Usher, for example. Usher was already a budding star from age 10 when he joined the R&B group New Beginnings. By age 13, Usher met L.A. Reid, the co-founder of Layface Records, who signed him on the spot after hearing him perform. While Usher was preparing for his debut album, he lost his voice and could not record. So L.A. Reid, who will come to his story later, started doubting Usher and he even wanted to drop him from the label. But Usher really wanted to remain on the contract and record his album. So, in the spring of 1994, L.A. Reid decided to send Usher to Diddy's house for what he called a puffy flavor camp, which was just a period of Usher being exposed to a lifestyle way too explicit for his age. In an interview with Rolling Stone, Usher described that period as one of his hardest days, where he was exposed to an adult lifestyle. He also claimed he witnessed some wild things, like randomly opening a door and seeing people going at it. Sometimes multiple people at once having an orgy. Mind you, Usher was 14 years old then, and Diddy was 23. The age difference alone sparked controversy, but it wasn't until Usher went on the Howard Stern show that he revealed that the situation was probably much worse than we might have expected. Among other things, Usher talked about the wild parties Diddy used to host, which created a toxic environment for a 14-year-old boy.
Was like just filled with chicks and orgying like nonstop, right?
Nah, not really. It was curious. I got a chance to see some things.
Yeah, but you were 13. What were you seeing?
I went there to see the lifestyle.
Right.
And I saw it. And it was, but I don't know if I could indulge and understand what I was even looking at. It was pretty wild. It was,
so nobody tried to, you know, some woman didn't come along.
I didn't say that.
Okay.
I didn't say that. What I did say is that there were very curious things taking place.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't necessarily understand it.
Uh-huh.
Biggie Smalls was there.
Lil' Kim, Craig Mack.
All these people are hanging around.
Yeah, man. Faith Evans. Jodeci, Mary
okay?
J. Blige. They ain't know nothing about this shit.
Oh.
I was having a good time. You know what I mean?
Does he have you doing any chores? Are you doing dishes at all? I mean, to keep you humble somewhat? Or are you just like, can you stay up till 4 in the morning with them and party?
I mean, I could. I actually stayed up longer than them.
Do you have money? What's going on?
I mean, I had like per diem. Yeah. Uh-huh. I had like, you know,
what
like
a
living.
Life.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
14 years old. You're a dad now. Would you ever send your kid to Puffy Camp?
Hell no.
See?
Also, Diddy allegedly paid Usher to stay with him, which is weird because why are you paying a child to live with you? The fact that Usher responded with a resounding hell no when Howard asked if he would let his kids go to a Puffy flavor camp tells you everything you need to know. Diddy himself has been seen making weird comments about Usher living with him. In a recently surfaced conversation between Diddy and Kevin Hart, Diddy talks about how 10-year-old Usher used to sleep in his bed and fight over Frosted Flakes. Given Diddy's track record, it makes you wonder if Usher was safe back then. I mean, why is there even a 10-year-old sleeping in your bed when you're like 19? However, Diddy having young boys sleep over at his house did not end with Usher. Justin Bieber allegedly had the same experience in 2009 when he spent 48 hours at Diddy's house to show Diddy the songs he had produced. And how old was Justin at that time? 15. Meanwhile, Diddy was 40 years old with kids. During the 48 hours Justin spent with Diddy, Diddy showed him a swanky Lambo, promising he would give it to him when he turned 16. He also promised Justin a mansion once he turned 18. Of course, he said all this as a little jokey joke, but joke or not, why would you, as an adult, promise a teenager such extravagant gifts? It's like grooming 101. Promise the victim extravagant gifts to keep them hooked and trust you. It's weird enough that a 40-year-old and a 15-year-old are hanging out in whatever capacity. But when you add promising a kid gifts like that, it seems way too creepy.
What's up, man? You good?
I'm good. How are you?
Hey, young brother. Everything's good? Selling out arenas and everything? Yeah, starting to act different, huh? You ain't been calling me and hanging out the way we used to hang out.
Well, I mean, you try to get in contact with me, you know, through all my, you know, partners and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
But you never really got my number, so.
Right. Okay.
My number?
Yeah.
Even creepier is this interaction Diddy and Justin had on camera, where Diddy is asking Justin why he never calls or tries to hang out with him. Justin looks so uncomfortable the whole time, but Diddy never even noticed. It just shows that Justin wouldn't have felt comfortable hanging out with Diddy for a whopping 48 hours.
Diddy had been trying to get to Bieber for a minute, and his management was backing him off. But it wasn't until Usher took over management and had guardianship and gave temporary guardianship to the diddler for 48 hours. Think about that. He had already been to the hospital. That situation that Gene was talking about. Mm. And you still took Bieber there. But you got custody of him first. Yeah. Diddy had already tried. They wouldn't let him. Actually, someone made reference to the fact that Diddy trying to get at Bieber the way he was trying to get at Bieber was looking a little predatory. And then Usher came in and discovered it and managed him and got custody of him and promised to look after him. And then he sent him to the diddler. Does that sound like a good guy?
It's horrible.
Does that sound like a good guy? Now that we know what Diddy's really like. They're not seeing what the intentions was in his heart when he took Justin Bieber there.
Oh.
Let's be honest. He took Justin Bieber there.
Yeah, what do I know? What do I know? So yeah, they're just showing, a lot of people are showing all this footage of them, people going at him like that. Tyler says, should Justin Bieber's mother also be liable for what happened to him? Well, I don't know what happened to him, you know, but if something did happen to him, then definitely she should be liable. Y'all remember, look, I don't know what's going on, but you remember the video of Justin about to give, who was he about to give? He was, it looked like he was about to give, I forget who was, he was about to get somebody hit at the club. Remember this? Yeah, so that happened too. You know, I don't know what's going on, but you know, Justin's, you know, look, I think that anybody that has been victim to this whole sex trafficking thing and what's going on in Hollywood and the music industry, you know, being a musician, it's just crazy because, I mean, I used to want that for myself so bad. And, you know, I don't know who has sold their soul and who hasn't. I don't know for sure anything. I'm just showing you, I could just show you what the evidence looks like. And it looks like Justin Bieber probably got passed around a little bit. And, you know, but that's also what enabled him to be as successful as he is, because they don't let nobody on top that they don't have full control over. So I don't know. I don't know. But I, you know, I don't have concern for his well-being at the moment because, you know, I don't think, you know, if Diddy's trying to get at somebody, it's going to be some of the guys above him. It's not going to be Justin. I don't see how I don't see how going after Justin is going to do anything for Diddy. But it's not just Justin. It's all the kids that are involved in all of this. I mean, in case you don't know, there are 300,000 children missing at the border since, you know, this whole border thing took place. And all of this is going for, you know, these sick politicians and musicians and everything else that's doing what they do. So, I mean, I can't call it. I got public concern probably just like y'all do. But I want to know what you think. So, you know, hit me back and tell me what you think. I mean, you think that, you know, did Bieber, you know, you think that actually happened? Or what?